Hello and welcome back. So this video is for class 9 and today we'll start with a new chapter, which is chapter number 11, work and energy. So till now we have seen the concept of gravitation, we saw the concept of forces. In this chapter we will see some other concepts, which are work, energy and also power, right? Now of course work is something that we have always heard about, right? We always talk about having a lot of work and we speak about doing a lot of work. Even now you would be saying that when you are attending the online class, you are doing a lot of work, and then after the class is over, you are going to be doing some writing work. But when we speak about work in terms of the scientific language, in physics when we talk about work, that work is very much different than what work you and I are doing. Okay, so in this chapter let us see what is meant by the work in the scientific terms. So now let us see what we mean by work in terms of science. Okay, so if you tell a scientist that you have been sitting in front of your mobile and attending classes, the scientist will say that you have done zero work. Okay, if you have just sat on your mobile or your laptop for 1 hour, 2 hours also, and you have done a lot of reading and writing, still the work done by you will be zero, right? So when is work done according to science? Science will say that if you have, let us say, one object having some mass m, okay, if you move this object from some point A to some point B, okay, if you have actually moved the object, then only you have done some work. And of course, to bring about this movement, to bring about this displacement, you will have to apply some force. So according to science, according to physics, only when there is some force applied and there is some displacement, then we will say that work has been done. Okay, is that understood? So if you are at one place only, you are doing zero work. But if you are moving an object from one place to another, then you have done some work. For example, let us say you are carrying your bag. Okay, then you move your bag from your class to the gate, school gate, right? So when you are doing this, now you have actually done some work, because you have brought about some displacement, right? So only when there is displacement, you will say that you have done some work. Okay, so that is the concept of work. But of course, that is not enough. Now we want to find out some formula for it. So let us see what is the formula. Alright, so now we want to find out a formula for work. Now as we said, if you want to do some amount of work, there must be some amount of force that should be applied. If this force is applied, then the object will move from point A to some point B, and there will be some displacement d, right? So object will be moving from A to B, and of course now you can find the displacement very easily. So we say that the work done in this case will be equal to the force multiplied by the displacement. So W is equal to F into D. Okay, that is the definition of work. Work is defined as product of force and displacement. Okay, that is the meaning. Then what will be the SI unit? Now SI unit, you will say, for force the SI unit is Newton and displacement SI unit is meter. So you can say SI unit of work is Newton meter. But instead of this, we use another unit and it is called as joule. Okay, J-O-U-L-E. So joule, and the symbol is J. So the SI unit of work is defined as joules. Okay, or you can call Newton meter, but the commonly used name is joule for it. So when we say that 1 joule of work is done, that means 1 newton of force is applied to bring a displacement of 1 meter. Okay, so 1 newton force you apply and the object moves by 1 meter, then you will say that 1 joule of work has been done. Okay, I think the formula in this is very much easy to understand. Now, there can be 3 types of work. Okay, what are the 3 types? One is positive, the other is negative, and third one is zero. Okay, now what is meant by positive work? Positive work means that if you are applying force, let us say from A to B, that is from left to right, and the object is also moving from A to B. So what you see here, the direction of force and direction of displacement is the same. So if force and displacement are in same direction, then you will say that you have done a positive work. right? So if force and displacement in the same direction, positive work is done. For example, if you want to push a car, okay, if you are pushing a car, then the car will move forward, your force is also forward, then now you will say that you have done a positive work, right? So if force and displacement are in the same direction, then we do positive work. Then what will be negative work? Negative work will be that if you are applying force in one direction but displacement is in the opposite direction, then we will say that we have done negative work, right? So you are applying force from left to right but displacement is from right to left, then you will say that you have done a negative work. Now of course you will think if such a thing is even possible. Let us see how. So how can we get negative work? Okay, the easiest example I can give you for negative work is when you are playing on the seesaw, right? So when you are playing on the seesaw, right, your friend is over here and you are over here. Okay, let us say friend is B and you are A, right? So if B applies a force in the downward direction, where will you move? You will move in the upward direction, right? So force is downwards but your displacement is upwards. That means opposite. So in this case, the work done by B is actually negative. Getting the idea? So this is one scenario. The other case you can imagine, if you are having a pulley and on that pulley you have put a rope and there is some mass that is attached to the rope. Now if you pull this rope downwards, right, force you apply it downwards, where the mass will move? Mass will move upwards. So in this case again you have done a negative work, right? So once again, if force and displacement same direction, positive work. But if force and displacement is opposite to each other, then you have done negative work, right? I think this is easy to understand. Then the third one, as I told you, is zero work. Zero work, when you will get? You will get zero work under two conditions. First condition is that the displacement should be zero. Okay, for example, there is a heavy object in a room. Okay, you take that object from one point, move it around the room, but again bring it to the same point. So if object has come back to the starting point, that will mean displacement is zero. And if displacement is zero, then we get W is equal to F into D. And if D is zero, of course work will be zero. So the work done will be zero if displacement is zero. That is first case. The second case that work done can be zero is if force is perpendicular to the displacement. So if you are having a case where the applied force is perpendicular, that is 90 degree to the displacement, in that case also you can do zero work. Let us examine this case. So it is easy to imagine either force in the direction of displacement or opposite to displacement. But what do we mean by force being perpendicular to the displacement? Okay, here is how you can understand. Let us say you are having a rope in your hand and to that rope you have attached a small stone and then you are moving that stone, right? So of course the stone will move in a circular path like this. Is that correct? Now to move the stone, where are you applying the force? You are applying the force on that string, on that thread. So force, this will be the direction of the force that is applied by, correct? And this the stone is moving in a circular path. So this will be the direction of displacement. So here you will see the displacement and force, they are perpendicular to each other. This is what we mean by force being perpendicular to displacement. So when this is being done, how much is the work? The work will be zero. Okay, so these are the three things that you will understand: positive work, negative work and zero work. Got it? Now the task is write down definition of work, write down formula and SI unit of work, and define positive, negative and zero work. Okay, so that's all for now.